Ladies and gentlemen, a very good day. My name's Callum from DX Commander. I'm ham radio operator and antenna guru. Well, keen antenna builder. Don't like the word guru. Makes me sound like somebody I'm not. But I made a video not so long ago about the difference, or what's best it was. What's best? Would it be a dipole or a vertical? And it was just an interesting comparison. We did a bit of software mucking around, and we looked at some far-field plots just to see what they did. Halfway through that video, I ended up saying that an inverted V was more omnidirectional than a regular flat-top dipole. So I thought what we'd do quickly, because I don't like long videos these days, is let's just have a quick untangle. So I'm firing up a couple of instances of something called MMANA, and there's a whole series of this on the channel. By all means, go and have a look. I'll put a link to the playlist down below somewhere, or certainly a link in the description to some of the relevant videos. Now, I've already made, right earlier on, an inverted V. There it is there. And over here, I happen to know we've flat top. Now, in my head, for some reason, I've got the flat top over on the right. So I'm just going to move them both around. Right, let's just go through what it is. You can see that is, if I just move that around a bit there, you can see that's actually a 45 degree, both sides of that dipole, 45 degrees. In other words, it's a 90 degree angle, all right? I'm sure you'll have 100 questions about this in a minute. We'll put them in the comments and we'll just make another video about it, because if I spend, you know, I could write a book just about this one antenna, right? So it's for 7 megahertz. The length of these doesn't matter, but it is 10 meters above the ground. The angle of dangle, Z minus 7.2. So it's about, the lowest leg is about 10 feet, 3 meters about, off the ground. So it comes down to, you know, just up here sort of thing. All right. So that's fine there. Let's just leave that there a minute. I'll make it out of copper wire. It doesn't matter what it's made from for this purpose. This is the same, but it's a flat top. Okay. And you can see that this is north-south. This one is north-south as well. There it is there, north-south. This one's north-south. Again, this is at, 12 metres height. So make it at 10, feed point is at 10 metres, and it's copper wire. I just need to check something. SWR's a tiny bit high. Let me just see where it is resonant. Hold on a minute. 7.15 will do. All right, that'll do. And what's this one at? 7.15. We'll have this at 7.15 as well. So the one on the left is the inverted V, and the one on the right is the flat top. And if you remember from the vertical versus dipole thing that we did, we can click this button here, which is the far field plot, and this is showing us the maximum gain. Probably, I think it defaults to 45 degrees off the horizon, and it did, nothing moved there. And we discussed in the last video, if you remember, that the DX is anywhere between sort of 3 and 8 degrees off of the horizon. It can be a bit higher too, don't get me wrong. And the reason that I benchmark all the antenna models I have at 5 degrees off the horizon, the reason is I just model everything there, and then I can compare everything apples with apples, okay? But on this one, we'll also do 45 degrees, because 10 meters off the ground, 30 odd feet, for a 40 meter dipole, you will find on a Sunday afternoon, you know, it'll work fine. The reason it'll work fine is this plot here on the right, which is a slice through the antenna field, if you like. And you can see a lot of our gain is going straight up in the air. Some of it's going out at the side as well. So if we go at 45 degrees off the horizon, I'm just forcing it there, and we can go around here, and we've got, it says here in the middle of the screen, 5.6, it says dBi, doesn't matter what it is, onions, bananas, right? It's 5.6, it's a number, okay? 5.6 there, and off the other side, the north side, north-south, it's 1.2. So that is a difference of 4, just over 4 dB between north-south or east-west. Okay, so that's at 45 degrees. Maybe we'll do the same here as well. So elevation, 45 degrees. And now we can spin around. We can say on the right-hand side, whereas this one was 5.6, this is 4.4. But north-south, this is the inverted V, it's 3 dB north-south, whereas this one was 1.2. So you can see it is almost 1.4 dB in it, north-south, east-west. So if you've got, you know, apple tree, right, an inverted V on 40 metres, there's absolutely no reason to worry whether it should be north-south, east-west or whatever. The difference comes on the DX, okay? So we will go down to 5 degrees off the horizon, okay? And there'll be probably some negative numbers now, but don't worry about that. Left, right, or east, west, it's minus 9.6 east, west. Now, if you remember, our vertical gave us, I think it was minus 4.6, 5.6, 6.6, 7.6, 8.6, 9.6. So we're nearly 2 S points lower on our 10-meter vertical. And the wire, remember, is running north-south in this model, okay? If we go over here now and do 5 degrees off the horizon, you'll see it's a little bit more of an omnidirectional pattern. So here it's north-south now. We're minus 18 on the flat top. And on the inverted V, not minus 18, we're minus 10. And over here, we're minus 11. So again, we are almost omnidirectional on the inverted V. Do you see that? Whoops. Do you see that? Minus 10, what are we at 45 degrees again? Oh yes, so we've already done that, haven't we? So the inverted V is giving us a bit of an omnidirectional, all right? Now you're gonna say, well, what happens if it's not quite an inverted V? Well, it's gonna be somewhere between the two, all right? Should we look at this if we move it up to the 20 meter band? Just for fun, let's see what happens. So we can go from 0.5, we want. Let's go to 14.3 megahertz there, and we will go to 0.5. 14 megahertz there, 14. We'll do 14.3 just to keep it all the numbers the same. All right, don't worry about that noise. That was my computer here. And again, don't worry about the SWR. The SWR doesn't make any difference really to the far field plot. Okay, so ignore the fact that it says 2.27. We can press this some button. I could prove it to you, but I'm not going to. How about that? Right. So we're still at 10 meters above the ground. So we've doubled the height above the ground as a percentage of the wavelength, haven't we? So let's have a look over here. Well, we can see it's a traditional dipole, not in free space, but that to me is just very much a dipole. What is this one doing? Well, this one's doing a bit the same. Now, by the way, I haven't done this test, but we're going to go down to 5 degrees off the horizon just to see what happens. Okay, so now we've got the height. North-south is minus 13 versus minus 6. And this one is minus 3.8. So 2 dB better on the flat top versus, what was it there? Minus 13. Ooh, minus 18 there. So in fact, we've taken some of the outside edge here on the inverted V. And we've moved it to the top, because you can't make any more RF than there really is. All right, if we take it from somewhere, we're going to put it somewhere else, unless there's losses. All right, so there we are. So quite interesting. What would I do? I don't think it really blooming matters, does it? As somebody said in the comments the other day, any antenna is better than no antenna. So there we are. That's settled that debate. Lower to the ground, inverted V gives you omnidirectional. Further up, it just gives you less of a null here, because that's the flat top. And that's the inverted V. Has that settled it? If you've got any more videos like this you want me to do, let me know in the comments. But otherwise, have a jolly good week. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you again next time. Bye for now. Let me start again. Ladies and gentlemen, a very good day.